Hey, what's up guys? TX309 here. For me, it is Tuesday, September 23rd, 8:09 a.m. And how about a thumbs up for a Wednesday video? I'm pretty sure some of you have noticed I am starting to record a lot of Battlefield 4. I decided to make a nice and quick comeback after I was given an idea for a series, and I hope you guys have been enjoying the gun challenges that I have uploaded so far. Do I have another one done? I don't think so. I think this is the only video that I had left so far. I've been recording a lot, I've been editing a lot, and I kind of been saving videos, and this is one of the reasons why you're getting to watch this right now. I want to talk a little bit about the fall patch, or the announcement that was made on Battlelog, and I kind of want to touch on a couple things that I'm excited for. And we're going to quickly look into the UMP45, which is another little gun challenge that I gave myself. If you guys remember, I unlocked this weapon during the Azdal challenge that I gave myself, which is some really good gameplay on that video as well, and I'll go ahead and post some links down below. But now, quickly, if I run out of time, there's going to be some random footage after the 750 mark. I don't think I was able to gather much UMP45 footage, but at least the clips that I have are pretty cool, in my opinion. Now, UMP45, max damage of 34 points, with a fire rate of 600 RPM. So, I was kind of difficult getting used to the UMP, seeing as how the Azdal is shooting at around 900. RPM, and there's something that really bothered me about the UMP45. As someone else noticed, one of my friends, Joe Spudge, he kind of noticed that from left to right I was having problems aiming with this thing, and we both thought that maybe it was a little bit of lag. But I did some research on the weapon itself, and it turns out that if you have this thing suppressed, you get a huge hit on your meters per second on your velocity, as it turns out. And there's a 320 meters per second, just a regular weapon on its own. And if you suppress this thing, as I do have it now, and this is the clip that I unloaded, uploaded about a week ago. When I have a full video on a Saturday, I like uploading little clips on a Wednesday, just so you guys know that I'm working on something. And in this clip, we noticed that once again I had problems shooting from left to right or from right to left, and it turns out your velocity speed goes from 320 down to 180 when the weapon is suppressed, and that's a big hit. And I kind of noticed that I was having a little bit of difficulty, and you kind of have to play around with that speed or with that weapon speed when you use this weapon. It's a really nice weapon, it's a satisfying weapon, and it's very satisfying to get kills with this thing. And it's a UMP45. I know it's a pretty popular weapon, and I do enjoy using it as I did in Battlefield 3. It shoots pretty straight, not a lot of problems with the thing aside from the suppression, or I mean the velocity speed when it is suppressed. But it turns out that a lot of weapons are gonna get a buff when it comes to being suppressed with the patch that is coming. So maybe the weapon will be a lot better when the changes come in for the fall patch. But as of now, it's kind of tricky using this thing while it is suppressed. It has a nice reload speed of 1.85 seconds when you do have ammo on the cartridge or on your magazine. And it has a 2.5 second reload speed when you're emptied out. So, as with any weapon, try to reload before any weapon goes empty. But of course, that depends on your battle situation, on how things are going. As you can see here, I was starting to reload when I should have switched right away when it comes to that battle situation that I just went through right now. But once again, UMP45, if you haven't used it, it's a beautiful weapon. It's a lot of fun using it. Aside from that, that suppression hit that it's taking at the moment, it's pretty tough. But once again, we'll see with the fall patch what kind of changes it takes. Now, I have about 5 different little notes that I took down from the fall patch. Of course, that is not a full list that we have at this moment in at Battlelog, but I'll go ahead and put that link in the description area if you guys want to see that link or that post that Battlelog made on their website if you haven't seen it yet. But as number one, player movement identical to BF3. Now this is huge for me. When it came to BF4, that's one of the biggest changes that I felt came to the game is movement itself on how sluggish and heavy the soldiers feel. In Battlefield 3, you felt a lot lighter. You had that bunny hopping action in Battlefield 3 that everyone loved to do. And I felt like just the game was faster. So we're going to see what that actually means when the patch comes out, but I'm really excited for that player movement change and the fall patch that is coming up. Now for number two, we have close and medium range sight reticles no longer affected by weapon firing animation. I also noticed that when it came to shooting weapons here in Battlefield 4, it just wasn't the same as Battlefield 3, and I'm not exactly sure what that means. If I noticed that it is a lot harder to take people down at medium to long ranges because you kind of get that movement on the weapon, but it looks like we're not going to be affected by that firing animation, and I'm taking that straight out of the website there. So shooting weapons might be easier now in Battlefield 4. We're just gonna have to wait and see what kind of changes come into play there. Now for number three, once again, that word netcode. Lowering setting for how much time difference is allowed when damaging other players. So it also said that less trading kills and less dying behind walls. Not really sure exactly what those changes mean in terms of what they're gonna do to the game, but as long as you stop trading kills and stop dying behind walls, that's a good change anytime in this case for Battlefield 4, as it doesn't happen as much as it used to, but it still does happen. Now, we were just talking about the bullet velocity for the UMP45, and as number four, I have faster bullet velocity for suppressed weapons, adjustment to slower rate of fire. So, once again, we just talked about that. There's no reason for me to go over that again. And for number five, we have easier to use at medium to long range. What does that mean? Easier to use at medium to long range, adjustment to slower rate of fire. I'm guessing that kind of connects to the firing animation, as I kind of just said that right now, right? I was talking about firing animations, how it we kind of get that movement with the weapons, and it should be easier to get kills at medium to long range. So I guess I kind of covered everything here, and those are my top five as of now when it comes to changes. Of course, every time they do changes to weapons, and I believe we're gonna have less grenades now, it's gonna be a slower reloading time or pickup time when it comes to grenades. So there's a couple changes coming into Battlefield 4. If I missed anything, go ahead and comment down below. And we're just gonna have to wait and see. I'm not really sure when this patch is due to come out, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be very soon, as fall came in yesterday here in the US, I believe, or 2 days ago. Aside from that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video once again. TX3089 coming to you live here from Los Angeles, California, and I'll see you guys on the battlefield.